Hi friends, today we'll see something about extrapyramidal symptoms or extrapyramidal syndrome. This is a condition that causes involuntary muscle movements and spasm. It occurs usually in the neck and face. It happens when the release and reuptake of neurotransmitter dopamine is not regulated properly. Extrapyramidal symptoms include various movement disorders such as acute dystonic reaction, pseudoparkinsonism, and third day dyskinesia. Let's have a look on that. First one is acute dystonic reactions. Muscular spasm of neck and eyes. Oculogenic crisis are more common in children. You can see in this picture. And pseudoparkinsonism. Drug-induced parkinsonism. You can see muscular rigidity, bradykinesia or akinesia, resting tremor and postural instability are more common in adults and elderly. You can see in this picture. Here see stooped posture and cogwheel rigidity in the arms and shoulders. And bradykinesia or akinesia, slowed body movements, shuffling and gait instability, resting tremor for the arms and legs, mask-like face. And next one is tardive dyskinesia, involuntary or irregular muscle movements in usually in the face. You can see in this picture. It occurs as a result of taking dopamine antagonists, usually neuroleptic drugs, which are often used to treat psychosis. The most common antipsychotic drug associated with extrapyramidal syndrome is haloperidol, which is used in schizophrenia. And other antidopaminergic drugs like antiemetics, for example, metoclopramide, we are calling Reglan, Primpran, or tricyclic antidepressants can also cause extrapyramidal symptoms. And cases are reported even after using propofol generalization. And brain damage also can cause extrapyramidal symptoms, for example, cerebral palsy. Now we'll see about the treatment. The treatment of these symptoms depends upon the medication that induced them and which symptoms are present. The first one, discontinue or decrease the medication that can cause extrapyramidal symptoms, and benzodiazepines are sometimes prescribed to counter-react on the symptoms. And the third one, use of anticholinergics, because usually antipsychotics are blocking the dopamine, and anticholinergics will increase the level of dopamine, and so it will become leveled out. Hope you learned something today. For more, you know what to do. Thanks for watching me. Bye bye.